And so I think for me, it's like this. It's coming to a place where I'm like, I'm not trying to work this religious ritual, and I'm not trying to abide by all these laws, all these rules, so God can love me more. And that's religion. I don't think I've ever been in that place where I'm trying to. I might have got over it to a couple times, you know, but got put correctly. But for me, it was like, you know, he said, he that forgives much loves much. And for me, it was like, I'd done so much wrong. I had so much sin that when he offered me forgiveness, when he offered that to me, I'm just talking about for me. And I knew I didn't deserve it. I settled that. I remember sitting down by the bed one day in the prison cell. And I said, you know, I said, I deserve hell. I deserve to be in hell right now. Everything I've done. No question. See, that was self-righteousness without it. It wasn't nothing. Well, you helped that person, you helped that woman one time, you did this good. You know, all that was out the door, and I was just sitting there like, deserve to die and go to heaven. Deserve it. And at that time, Jesus speaking to me, telling me that he loved me. And like that guy said that we was talking about earlier, you know, I love him because he first loved me. And he offered me something that nobody else could have. So for me, this thing is all wrapped up in one thing. I wanted to live every day of my life from that day forward to please him. Not to earn it, to show gratitude. To show that I was grateful for the gift that I've been given. And I remember being in that cell one day, and I said, you know, Pastor Jody, I said, Lord, I know he delivered me from drugs, and if he did that, the man that I was, the drug addict that I was, he could do anything. I told him one day, I said, Lord, because I didn't know, I still had 3 years to get out of prison, I'm still involved in this prison gang, I didn't know. My heart had changed, I didn't know anything else, that's all I knew for 10 years. That's all I knew. I didn't know my other life. 10 years of my life, that's all I knew, the gang, the prison, that's all I knew. I mean, life outside of there was almost non-existent. I said, Lord, I said, I'll tell you, if you let me out of this prison, you let me walk out here one day, I said, I'll do everything I can for you. And he's holding my feet to the fire now. But so I think to answer those questions about religion is, you know, do questions gender strife? I mean, what was the question? Why are we asking the questions that we ask? You know, what is the purpose of them? I mean, is it to justify you being disobedient to God? Is it to justify your lifestyle that you don't want to live in? Because for me, Christianity is just summed up in one thing. Is this love for the one that enslaved you. When he showed me that after hearing that message, because that message really convicted me. And he showed me, he said, even in judgment, he said, people are going to stand there and they're going to realize that I'm the only reason they're here. Period. That's why he said all knees will bow and all tongues will confess. The blood is the only thing that covers your sin. Period. So you can look at Christianity all kinds of different ways. We can bring you to accountability in some areas and all that, but if you don't get that heart on fire, your mind made up. You know, that you're going to serve. I don't mean to get emotional with you, but this is what this is about. Just get real with people. Just being vulnerable. So I think living every day of my life to please me. and see as many people as we can to be saved and to become disciples of His. I think that's what I run for. Because I know life is but a vapor. I mean, we see people here and they're dead. They don't. I'm not declaring I'm leaving tomorrow. I want to finish my prayer. But when I got a revelation of eternity, I no longer ran for the natural. I ran for the long haul. I run for the eternal treasure. I run for the eternity. I run for because I know one day I'm gonna step out of this body and I'm gonna be in eternity, and that's the only thing gonna count. Only thing that's gonna count in that moment is what I did with this life. That's the only thing gonna count. There's gonna be no going back. There's gonna be no saying, Jesus, send me back in my body. Let me do it over. Let me do this. Let me forgive this person. Let me make this right with them. Let me make it right with my wife. Let me do this right. Let me do that right. No, there ain't gonna be no going back. There ain't gonna be no. You're gonna be there. Everything, your whole life, everything will flash before your eyes right there in that moment. You're gonna stand before a holy God, and everything is gonna be revealed as it is. Your intentions, everything that you did, every intention that you had when you did it, everything's going to be revealed out there in that moment. And I think even at the end, you're going to see. And you're going to stand there before Jesus, and you're going to realize that He's the only reason that you're standing where you are and that you're saved. And that's going to make Him more magnified, more loved, more honored in that moment. And you realize the price that was paid for you. And so I think for me, Christianity, back to this place of being real, is living every single day of my life. From the time I get up to the time I go to bed. Not to earn His love, but to show gratitude and be grateful for the price that He paid for me and for what He done for me.
Yes, that's good.
When you live like that, you're no longer trying to work, because He's not a respecter of persons. He don't love you more than He loves me. God don't work that way. His word's pretty clear on that. He paid the price for every single person. He made it available to whosoever will. He said, let them come. Now, where you see other people walking in greater levels with God, and walking in greater anointings and more blessed than other people, it ain't necessarily because He loves you more. Maybe you've been more obedient. Or maybe that person's been more obedient than you have. They've obeyed God. You see people that run great ministries and stuff, and you say, man, how'd they get there? Well, go to the early years of their ministry. And they was obeying God and the things that nobody was looking at, but they was doing the things that nobody seen. But God seen it, and God was telling them to that the obedience was what mattered. So where favor comes in your life is this. Favor is not given just because you're a son. You're a son of God, that brings you into the life of God, yeah. But now there's a life of this following and leading, you being obedient and responding to what He tells you and leads you to do. And those things is what leads you into your inheritance and what leads you into a greater life with Him. And now I could go on and talk. Are we still on? No?
Yeah.
You recording it? And so... This is some good stuff right here, man. This is good. I didn't know we was getting into this. So what if you got anything that you want to add? And just talk. Just be you, man.
I'm just
and I ain't trying to get emotional in that sense, but you know, Dr. Barclay says the same thing. Yeah, he says it, and I don't say it just because he said it, but I have to judge my life, and you have to do that for yourself. You have to evaluate yourself. You have to evaluate you. You at the end of the day is responsible. Evaluate yourself. Mm-hmm. You have to evaluate. You have to take inventory of your life, of your intentions, of what you're doing, why you're doing it, Your motives. There you go. Motives is more important than what you're doing. Mm-hmm. What you're doing is important, but why are you doing what you're doing? That's the important thing. Why do I do it? Because that's what's going to be exposed. That's what's going to be, you know, that's what's going to be brought to light, my motives and why I did it. You know, were they pure? Was there an ulterior motive there? Dr. Barclay says that all the time. He said at SCTI, he'd say, you know, what if I just live? He said, I just live every day of my life, you know, to show him how thankful that I am for the life that he gave me. And I don't say that just because he said that, but I evaluate my own life, and I'm trying to get deep, and I'm trying to get real here to the point to where I'm very vulnerable, but I feel like I need to be that way with you because I've got to be me. I can't be nobody else. I can't be Jesse the Plantis. I can't be none of them. And so for me, it's a place of gratitude, a place of thankfulness. So that's why I run the way I run. That's why I try to be obedient every single day of my life, not to displease in any way, because of my gratitude, my thankfulness for what the life that he's given me. Because I never knew life until he gave it to me. I was lost and undone, and he came, and I didn't deserve it. Mm-hmm. And he came at a time when I truly deserved to be in him. At that time, I deserved it. And knew it. And so he offered me life, and he gave it to me. I told him I'd do anything for him. That's why we're sitting here tonight. Mm-hmm. That's why we're in this church. That's why I'm doing what I do. That's why we're talking about, you know, our life right now is like this. I'm almost at this point where, I mean, I can't just do what I want. I can't just go where I want. I can't, you know, I literally can't. I can't get up tomorrow and say, well, I'm just going to drive to Florida, you know, and I'm just going to drive to, you know, down to East Tennessee, you know. If God ain't telling me and leading me, I can't do it. I can't. I'm not able to, nor do I want to. And that'll continue to get finer and finer and finer as we go. Again, I want to say this to you. You never know life until you know life in Him. You never know what life is until you experience it in Christ. Again, life is but a vapor. Whether you're here 50 years, whether you're here 60 years, whether you're here another 80, whether you're here 20, whether you're here 5, life is but a vapor. You know, I don't sing the regular music, you know, anymore. But I remember a song that comes to me, and this guy was sitting on a bench, and he was 101 years old. And this person sat down beside of him, and he's sitting there, you know, and he's old. And he says, the young guy sits down, and he says, hey, what can you tell me about your life? Is there anything that you can tell me? Any words of wisdom? I'm just adding my own, but this is kind of a story. Is there any words of wisdom that you could give me? And he said, yeah, don't blink. He said, what do you mean? Don't blink. Just like that, you're 15 and you got a girlfriend. And then just like that, you're married. And then don't blink. Just like that, now you had a kid. Just like that, you've got a grandkid. Just like that, boom, you blink. He said, so his word of wisdom to the young man was don't blink. It's going to go by. And at the end, you're going to look back and you're going to have to answer. You're going to have to, and the only thing that's going to matter is what you stored up in eternity. That's it. There'll be no going back. All that waste of time, you look at all that stuff that you did, and did it amount to eternity? Did it stack up any treasures in heaven? Did it win souls? Did it make disciples? Did it change lives? Was it something that Jesus told us to do? Or was it something that we just decided to do, or we just wanted to do? You know, I remember Charles Stanley said this right here. He said, a lot of people are going to get to heaven, and they're going to have a pile of ashes, because everything they give is going to burn up. He's eternal security, I think. Everything they did is going to burn up. Because he said our works would be tried by fire. So the works that we've done are going to be tried by fire for the intentions, and was it in obedience to God? And he said, a lot of people are going to have a pile of ashes standing there, and they're going to have to go to school. You know, in heaven. Well, thank God they get in by the skin of their teeth, but I don't want to get in that way. I want to walk up to the throne, and the angels are standing. You know, not to say anything, but me to fall down at Jesus' feet, and Jesus to say, son, come on in there. Our good faith, sir. And the crown that you get, you throw it in his feet because you don't want it. Because it means nothing. The only thing that means anything is him. your awards. They don't mean that much to you, even though we're receiving, but at the end of the day, what matters is because in that moment you're gonna see everything gonna flash, everything's gonna be revealed for what it is. Just like he said to me, the only thing that's gonna matter in that moment, you're gonna see him and you're gonna be more in love with him, because you're gonna see that he's the only reason. The price that he paid for you, what he did for you, is the only reason that you have a chance to be where you're at. The only chance that you're saved. The only reason that you're saved. Because your faith in him, you turn to him. And I believe this, if you don't ever get to a place of gratitude like that in your life, it's going to be hard for you. If you don't ever come to this place in your Christian walk where you've hit the bottom and you're truly grateful for where you're at, you're truly grateful for the process, baby.
Yeah.
You're truly grateful for the new creation life that you have. It'll be hard. You could possibly still be saved, but it'd be good. You know? So with that being said, I don't want to keep on going and going, and I know this will be shared later. I leave you with anything after this session. It's gratitude. If we can get to a place of, and I've been there, and I've had to deal with myself in a lot of ways here lately, because we get to this place, God's favor, because of our obedience and blessings, because of our obedience to the Word of God, and so in the reaping, and that. You can almost get to a place where you think, well, people owe you, or you get ungrateful because you forget. You forget how close you was to eternity. You forget how close you was and how miserable your life was. And that's why he said you overcome by the blood of the Lamb, the word of the testimony. If you keep the testimony, you tell those things, even if it's to yourself, it's like we did tonight. Because this brought me back to that place. No longer am I looking at anything other than being grateful for the price that was paid for me and the life that he gave me. So with that being said, I'm going to say those of you that maybe are watching, if the Holy Ghost has spoke to you through this message, and you're sitting there and maybe you've lost your gratitude. Maybe you've lost your thing. Maybe you just need to remember. You just need to remind yourself. And maybe there's somebody that say, well, you know, I haven't done all those things. I haven't sinned that much. Well, if you, in God's eyes, it's like this. In God's eyes, he said, if you missed it, if you sinned once, if you committed one sin, he said, you're guilty of the whole law. Therefore, you're in judgment. You got to face judgment for that sin. There's only one way out of that, and that's by faith in Christ Jesus. Christ that he paid for you, for the blood that he shed on the cross to cleanse you of that sin, and your name will be written in the Lamb's Book of Life. That's the only hope for you. So with that said, I think that sums it up right there. Good question that sister had about the all that, and about a heart of gratitude. Sometimes you just need to go back. You just need to, think about where you was at. Think about what you was, what was happening. Think about when Jesus came to you. Think about when he came back to you. Think about when he offered that back to you. Think about when he sent somebody to you. He cared enough about you to send his messenger, to send his prophet, to send his evangelist, to send his Christians, to send one of his people to you. He cared that much to send them to reach out to you and say, hey, well, God still loves you, or whatever the message was that caused you to turn in that moment. And go back to that place of gratitude and never leave that place. If we stay in that place, man, God can do amazing things through us. And it'll also keep us in an eternal perspective, not just a temporal. Because a lot of times we get this temporary, we just think, oh, it's now, it's microwave society, yeah, that's right, but it's just what I got now, what I can get now, how I can be blessed now. But how is that going to affect eternity? eternity? What is that going to matter? What is what you're doing? How is that going to matter for eternity? Well, I can tell you what we're doing now, how it's going to matter for eternity, because we're preaching the gospel together as a team. You know, just because I'm the one speaking, there's still a whole team that's connected here. There's still a whole church that's connected here, that's together in unity, that's seeing this message and these testimonies go out, that lives are going to be changed. And this is going to matter for eternity. This is what's going to have eternal treasures and rewards. At the end, our salvation rests in one name only, in the name of Jesus Christ. And that's it. That's it. So when it's not a, I'm trying to earn this, if you think you can earn it, he said, that's self-righteousness. If you think you can earn your salvation, you've already fallen from grace. You can't earn this. That's what the Jews did. They went back into this thinking they could be right with God by their rituals, by their rules, by their regulations. And he said, you fallen from grace. Instead of coming to a place where you receive what he's offering you, you receive the life that he's given you, you lay down your old life, you die, you receive his life, and the grace that's being offered to you, and the mercy that's being extended to you. And now from that place, he empowers you to overcome sin. He empowers you to do what you could not do otherwise. That's salvation. That's Christianity. And now I live a life every day on fire because I don't want to displease him, and I want to bring honor to his name. Not because I'm earning my salvation, because I can't earn it. But I can show my gratitude. I can show my thankfulness that I'm thankful for what he's done. And that's something that we can do. You know what I mean? So now my perspective shifts. And now my vision becomes more clear. And now my life can change. My Christian walk can change. So with that being said, gratitude. That's I think the message here. Be grateful. Be grateful for the price that was paid for you. Be grateful that life was offered to you and you didn't deserve it. Mm-hmm. So if you missed it, again, you missed it. One point, those of you saying, well, I didn't do all those things. I paid time. I didn't do that. Yeah, if you're giving me your credentials, I already know that you're probably in trouble because you're already giving credentials instead of just pointing to one name in the name of Jesus. Why are you here, Pastor? Why are you saved, Jesus? Why are you right with God, Jesus? See if I start giving my, why are you right with God? Oh, because I pay tithes, because I'm at church, because I'm there. No, those are fruits from my life. Those ain't what make me right with God. That's religion. Why am I here to serve every Sunday? Why am I here where I'm supposed to be on assignment? Not so I can be right with God. I'm here because that's a fruit of my life lived in surrender to him, submission to him. My life is in surrender and submission to him. Your life is in surrender and submission to him. You're doing what you do because you're surrendering to him. You're submitting to him. It ain't what makes you right. I go down there and I say, well, I'm preaching every Sunday. I don't miss a service. I ain't missed one. I'm not there. I'm there. I'm not there. I'm there on time every time. You know what? They ain't. You know? And now I'm more of a Christian than you because I've been there and you ain't. You see the mindset? Now, on the other hand, is that to say, well, okay, I'm not going to be faithful. You know, I'm not going to be, and then it's all because of Jesus, right? Well, that's not a good mindset to be in. That's not accountability. You know? So you got to rightly divide the word, but just gratitude. I'm going to close with that. Gratitude is what you want to do, what you want to keep. Gratitude. You want to make sure you keep that grateful heart. That God loves you. He's for you. He's given you life when you didn't deserve it. Now you can be anointed. You can live the life that he's called you to live. As who? As son of God, as son of man. As Son of God, as Son of Man, new creations in Christ. Hallelujah. We're going to close with that in Jesus' name.